Hi, and welcome to the Stipulism tutorial. I'm Alice, and in this episode, I'll be taking you through where to locate your Stipulism plugin. Overall, we'll cover opening the menu, previewing the stipple, accessing the effect through the appearance panel, and finally, where to find the Create Symbol Variants option. Think of this plugin as being made up of two live effects, the first being a traditional stipple, and the second being symbol stipple, which enables user-defined dots through the use of symbols. If you're still a little unsure of Illustrator, I would definitely recommend changing your workspace to Essentials for all of the following tutorials, meaning your Illustrator setup is as similar to mine as possible, making everything easier to follow. To do this, just go to the Window menu, scroll to Workspace, and then tick Essentials. Okay, so let's get started. In order to access Stipulism, we will need to have an object selected. Let's start with this black gradient fill. Both stipple and symbol stipple are live effects, so can be found up the top here in the Effect menu. Scroll down to Additional Effects, and you'll find both under Stipulism. When selecting either effects, a menu will appear with a default setting already loaded. In order to see the effect in action, just click at the bottom here on the preview button. Cancel to cancel. And OK to apply the effect and exit the menu. Really simple. When using Stipulism, I would recommend opening the All Important Appearance panel. To do this, go to the Window menu and then select Appearance. Any beginners watching this who are not yet familiar with the appearance panel, it is a must, as it gives you access to any live effects you have applied to your selected artwork, as well as any appearance attributes such as the fill, stroke, opacity, as well as our stipple. As with any of these, you can toggle them on and off by clicking the little eye. Most importantly, in order to access and change the settings of your stipple, you need to click on the word stipple, which will open the menu again with the current settings loaded. So all the changes you make will be made through these menus, except this one option up here in the object menu, which allows you to create symbol variants, which I'll cover further in a later episode. Which brings an end to this tutorial. Just to recap, we've covered opening the stipple and symbol stipple menu, using preview and the appearance panel, as well as where to find the create symbol variants option. Now you know where to find everything, make sure you check out the following Stipulism episodes where you'll learn its full creative potential. Not bought Stipulism yet? Try our 14-day trial here and let us know what you think. Thanks for watching.